Hello everyone, I am Dr. Trupti. Welcome to my YouTube channel Enjoy Biochemistry. Today's topic is heteropolysaccharides, and more specifically you are going to learn about mucopolysaccharides or glycosaminoglycans. Carbohydrates are classified as monosaccharides, disaccharides, oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. In polysaccharides there are two types, homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. So polysaccharides constitute of more than or equal to 10 monosaccharide units, and heteropolysaccharides, they contain more than two different monosaccharide units or their derivatives. Heteropolysaccharides are also called as heteroglycans. Hetero means different units, and glycan, this word is related to carbohydrates. So the various examples of heteropolysaccharides are agar, agarose, gum and pectin, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate, keratin sulfate, dermatin sulfate, heparin sulfate. So out of these heteropolysaccharides, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate, keratin sulfate, dermatin sulfate, heparin sulfate, they are also called as mucopolysaccharides or glycosaminoglycans. Mucopolysaccharides, because they were first discovered in mucin, and that's why they were named as mucopolysaccharides. They are also called as glycosaminoglycans or GACs. Glycosaminoglycans, amino because they contain amino sugar, and that's why the word glycosaminoglycans. Before studying glycosaminoglycans in detail, let's take a look at few important points about agar, agarose and pectin. Agar is mostly found in seaweeds. It is the polymer of galactose, sulfate and glucose. It is non-digestible dietary fiber, and at times it is given to provide bulk to the feces in the treatment of constipation. Agarose is made up of galactose and unhydrogalactose. It is useful in laboratory as a major component of microbial culture media, and it is also used in the electrophoresis. Agar is also used to form a surface for the growth of bacterial colonies. Pectins are made up of galactouronate and rhamnose. They are non-digestible dietary fibers. They are found in apples and citrus fruits and employed in the preparation of jellies. Glycosaminoglycans are long, negatively charged. They are negatively charged due to presence of sulfate group and carboxylic group. They are linear, that is unbranched, heteropolysaccharide chains generally composed of repeating disaccharide unit, that is acidic sugar, either glucuronic acid or hyaluronic acid, and amino sugar, that is glucosamine or galactosamine. Glycosaminoglycans, they are associated with a small amount of protein and they form proteoglycans. Proteoglycans, they contain more than 95% of carbohydrates and less than 5% of protein, unlike glycoprotein, which has more than 95% of protein and less than 5% of carbohydrates. So these glycosaminoglycans, they form a proteoglycan monomer. The glycosaminoglycans, they are bound to this core protein covalently. So this green one is a core protein, and glycosaminoglycans like chondroitin sulfate, keratin sulfate, they are linked to this core protein by covalent bond, and it appears like a bottle brush, and this is a proteoglycan monomer. Now these proteoglycan monomers, they are further linked with the hyaluronic acid. This blue one is hyaluronic acid, but the attachment of this proteoglycan monomer to this hyaluronic acid is non-covalent. They are attached non-covalently with the hyaluronic acid, and that with the help of this link protein. So this is the structure of proteoglycan aggregate. Now where does this aggregate exist? So it is the important constituent of extracellular matrix along with the collagen, elastin and other important proteins. Now let's see some important properties and functions of glycosaminoglycans. These glycosaminoglycans, they exist as proteoglycan, which is the major component of extracellular matrix, which support cellular and fibrous components of tissues and mediate cell-to-cell signaling and adhesion. And these glycosaminoglycans, they are negatively charged due to presence of carboxyl and sulfate group. And because it is negatively charged, it binds to the positively charged ions and they form hydrogen bonds with water molecules. And thereby they produce gel-like matrix. And this gel provides a flexible mechanical support for the extracellular matrix and functions as cushion and lubricant against mechanical shock. So it binds large amount of water, it is viscous and lubricating. Now, because of its long negatively charged glycosaminoglycans chain, they repel each other, and because of these proteoglycans, they also act as a molecular sieve. They also give resilience, that is elasticity, to substances such as cartilage, permitting compression and re-expansion. So when a solution of glycosaminoglycans is compressed, the water is squeezed out and glycosaminoglycans are forced to occupy a smaller volume. And after releasing the compression, the glycosaminoglycans spring back to the original hydrated volume. And when this property is lost in conditions like osteoarthritis, so there is loss of water from this proteoglycans, and this happens with aging. Coming to the structure and composition of glycosaminoglycans, composition of glycosaminoglycans is must know for students. So glycosaminoglycans, they are the repeating disaccharide unit which consists of amino sugar and uronic acid. The amino sugar can be glucosamine or galactosamine, and the uronic acid can be either glucuronic acid or its epimer iduronic acid. This is the structure of glucosamine, where amino group is attached to carbon number 2. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is the structure of glucosamine. Galactose is the fourth epimer of glucose. Only difference between the structure of glucosamine and galactosamine or glucose and galactose is that the change in position of hydroxyl group. So this is the fourth epimer of glucose, and amino group is attached at the carbon number 2. So this is the structure of galactosamine. So amino sugar present in the glycosaminoglycans can be either glucosamine and galactosamine. Further, this amino sugar can be either acetylated or sulfated. So if it is acetylated, it is called as N-acetylglucosamine, where acetyl group is attached to the amino group. And when it is sulfated, when sulfate group is added at carbon number 6, it is called as N-acetylglucosamine 6 sulfate. And when many sulfate groups are added, like for example, sulfate group is added to amino group as well as it is added to the 6th carbon, then it is called as N-sulfoglucosamine 6 sulfate. So the amino sugars present in glycosaminoglycans, they are acetylated, and they are both acetylated as well as sulfated. Galactose is present in the glycosaminoglycan, that is keratin sulfate. It is the only glycosaminoglycan which does not contain uronic acid, keratin sulfate. And N-acetylgalactosamine, it is present in two glycosaminoglycans. The first is chondroitin sulfate and the other is dermatin sulfate. The uronic acid which are present in glycosaminoglycans, either glucuronic acid or iduronic acid. This is the structure of glucuronic acid and iduronic acid. There is just a difference of this carboxylic group which is present in glucuronic acid, and it is present here in iduronic acid. So it is L-iduronic acid and it is D-glucuronic acid. So up till now we have studied that glycosaminoglycans, these are the heteropolysaccharides chain which are linear, unbranched, negatively charged. They are long and they are made up of repeating disaccharide units containing amino sugar and acidic sugar or uronic acid. And the examples are hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate, keratin sulfate, heparin, heparin sulfate, and dermatin sulfate. The first gag is hyaluronic acid. The composition is, it consists of repeating disaccharide unit, and this disaccharide unit is made up of two units, that is first is glucuronic acid and the other is N-acetylglucosamine, and both are linked together with beta-1,3 glycosidic linkage. Now the characteristic feature of this hyaluronic acid are, it is different from other GACs. How it is different? Because this hyaluronic acid, it is unsulfated. No sulfate group is added to this N-acetylglucosamine. And this is not covalently attached to protein. All other glycosaminoglycans, they are attached covalently, but hyaluronic acid is attached non-covalently. This is the only GAG which is not limited to animal tissue. So it is also present in bacteria. It is found in synovial fluids of joint, vitreous humor of the eyes, the umbilical cord, loose connective tissue and cartilage. And the function is, it serves as lubricant and shock absorber. Hyaluronic acid contains 250 to 25,000 disaccharide units, and two such disaccharide units, they are linked together by beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. The disaccharide unit is linked together by beta-1,3 glycosidic linkage, but two such disaccharide units, they are linked together by beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. Now, the enzyme hyaluronidase, it breaks this beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage, which is present between two disaccharide units. And this hyaluronidase, it is present in seminal fluids, certain snake and insect venoms. Now, why it is important? Because the hyaluronidase of semen, it has important role in fertilization. Because this hyaluronidase, it clears the gel, that is hyaluronic acid, around the ovum, allowing better penetration of sperm into the ovum. And that's how it has role in fertilization. Hyaluronidase in bacteria helps their invasion into animal tissues. Second glycosaminoglycan is chondroitin sulfate, and the composition is beta-D-glucuronic acid, and the amino sugar here is N-acetylgalactosamine 4-sulfate, because sulfate group is attached to the fourth carbon, and that's why it is called as chondroitin 4-sulfate. If the sulfate group is attached to the sixth carbon, it is called as chondroitin 6-sulfate. Now this beta-D-glucuronic acid is linked to this N-acetylgalactosamine 4-sulfate by beta-1,3 glycosidic linkage. This chondroitin sulfate, the characteristic features are, it is the most abundant GACs in the body, and it is found in cartilage, tendons, ligaments and aorta. This chondroitin sulfate, it forms monomer. It is linked to this core protein covalently, and it forms proteoglycan monomer. And this proteoglycan monomer then gets attached to the hyaluronic acid non-covalently to form proteoglycan aggregates. It is present in the cartilage. They bind collagen and hold fibers in a tight, strong network, and thus helps to maintain the structure and shape of tissues. Dermatan sulfate is the glycosaminoglycans which has L-iduronic acid or with variable amounts of glucuronic acid. And it is linked to N-acetylgalactosamine 4-sulfate by beta-1,3 glycosidic linkage. So this is the glycosaminoglycan which has galactosamine as amino sugar other than chondroitin sulfate. So both chondroitin sulfate and dermatan sulfate both have galactosamine as their amino sugar. And this dermatan sulfate, it has iduronic acid as well as variable amount of glucuronic acid as well. It is found in skin, blood vessels and heart walls, and it maintains the shape of skin. Keratin sulfate, it consists of beta-D-galactose and N-acetylglucosamine 6-sulfate, and both are linked together by beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. So this is the only GAG which does not have uronic acid. It has galactose. So it is the only GAG which does not have uronic acid. It is found in cornea and tendons, and keratin sulfate is responsible for keeping the cornea transparent. Then comes heparin. Heparin consists of L-iduronic acid 2-sulfate or glucuronic acid. It can contain glucuronic acid as well, and the amino sugar is N-sulfoglucosamine 6 sulfate. So it has glucosamine, and both are linked together by alpha 1,4 glycosidic linkage. So this is the composition of heparin, that is L-iduronic acid plus N-sulfoglucosamine. What are the characteristic features of this heparin? Unlike other GACs, all other GACs are extracellular, but only heparin is intracellular component of mast cells that line our arteries, especially in the liver, lungs and skin. And being in the intracellular, it is intracellular and it serves as an anticoagulant. It activates antithrombin 3, which in turn inactivates thrombin, and so blood is not clotted, and that's how it acts as anticoagulant. So the specific characteristics about this heparin, it is intracellular and it serves as an anticoagulant. Now, what is the difference between heparin and heparan sulfate? Heparan sulfate is also disaccharide unit, same as the disaccharide unit present in heparan sulfate is same as that of heparin, that it consists of iduronic acid and N-sulfoglucosamine, except some glucosamines are acetylated and there are fewer sulfate groups. So less sulfate group are present in heparin sulfate, and it is the extracellular unlike heparin. It is found in the basement membrane and it is the ubiquitous component of cell surfaces. Let's summarize today's topic, that is glycosaminoglycans, which are heteropolysaccharides, and these are also called as mucopolysaccharides. The examples are hyaluronic acid, heparin, heparan sulfate, keratin sulfate, chondroitin sulfate and dermatin sulfate. Now let's see the characteristic features of these glycosaminoglycans. The composition is very important, and every student should know the composition and characteristic features. So the hyaluronic acid is made up of glucuronic acid and N-acetylglucosamine. So the uronic acid is glucuronic acid here and the sugar is glucosamine. It is unsulfated GAG, so no sulfate group is present. Hyaluronic acid is not covalently attached to any other protein, and it is also present in bacteria. Heparin composition is L-iduronic acid and it has sulfated glucosamine. This is the only GAG which is intracellular and it is also anticoagulant. The composition of keratin sulfate is that it consists of galactose and the amino sugar is N-acetylglucosamine. And this is the GAG which does not contain any uronic acid. No glucuronic acid, no iduronic acid. It just contains galactose and N-acetylglucosamine. And the keratin sulfate one is responsible for the corneal transparency. Chondroitin sulfate, it consists of glucuronic acid and N-acetylgalactosamine. So the amino sugar here is galactosamine. This is the most abundant GAG. Dermatin sulfate is consist of L-iduronic acid and N-acetylgalactosamine. So other than chondroitin sulfate, dermatin sulfate is the GAG which has amino sugar, that is galactosamine. Now let's quickly see some important MCQs. The glycosaminoglycans present in synovial fluid is heparin, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate or keratin sulfate. So it is hyaluronic acid. Which of the following glycosaminoglycan is intracellular? Is it heparin, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate or keratin sulfate? So it is heparin. Hyaluronic acid is present in vitreous humor, mast cell, cornea or dermis. So it is present in vitreous humor. The heteropolysaccharide that does not contain uronic acid is it keratin sulfate, dermatin sulfate, chondroitin sulfate or hyaluronic acid? So it is keratin sulfate.